One of the questions I hear a lot is how does SmartPest handle renewal? Because of that, we have given a lot of thought to this process, and we realize that a lot of people build the value of their company based upon their number of renewals. And historically, this has been an area that software has been lacking. So we're very happy to announce that we have a very powerful but easy to use system with our renewals. So as you see here, we have a client that has purchased renewals. In 2008, they had a renewal that was renewed in 2009. And then in 2010, for some reason, they haven't renewed. So one of the features that we've built in is the ability to find anybody who hasn't renewed. And that's found in the report menu at the top of the page, just out of your view here. And it's called Pending Renewals. So in this case, we come down to our date selector, and the date selector allows you to select from a lot of options, or you can put in a custom date selection and select the starting date and the ending date you want to use. The all feature is essentially the same thing here with nothing in it. So if you leave the start date and the end date blank, that is the same as all. So we want to know anything that hasn't renewed, but it is pending. In other words, there's a renewal been created, but nobody has responded. And this is an area where basically it's lost money. A lot of people just don't have time to go back and trace those. So we make it real simple. Just hit the continue button, and you come up to a list that shows your pending renewals. So you can see this particular renewal is the one that we were looking at originally, and it appears that we have a new name and probably don't have the follow-up information we need, and we kind of lost track. So you might want to use this to chase it down. Let's say that you get a hold of them on the phone, and maybe they even give you a credit card. Well, right here from this renewal form, you can create the invoice. So I just hit Create Invoice, and you'll see that the invoice has been created. We can go apply the payments, paid in full. And let's say that we used a Visa. So now that record has been updated, but we still have the contact name to deal with. So we can enter that. So now if we go back to our report menu, run our pending renewals, and you'll see we're now down to one pending renewal. Now the other report that will be of interest to you is what we call our expiring warranties. In order for expiring warranties to be included in the report, you have to have a date, an expiration date that shows up in this window. So you can either enter that date there or under the warranty tab. Now also under the warranty tab, we have the ability to create categories. So we have a termite category that's preset, or the carpenter ant preset. And as a way of a reminder, these categories are created in the services area under the tab renewals. You type in what you want to call your renewal type, the renewal letter you want to make, which is from your form document area, the service, which is from your services area, which also includes the pricing. So it's quite simple to set various renewal types up. And you also have a status, so I'm going to mark this completed. And I'm going to click this original renewal, which will take you back to the renewal form that was used to generate that invoice. And while I'm on this, I'll point out that you can title this. Let's say that you wanted this called an annual termite renewal. It could be called an annual termite renewal. And then you have the ability, to add your logos. And then you also can have first notice, second notice, final notice. So if you were running your pending renewals and you noticed someone had not responded, you could create a second notice just by changing this field, print that or email that to your customer. And again, you might have a second follow-up notice here that is a little different from your original. But that keeps it all in the same area. And you'll notice that this also has a dotted line here so that you can have a remittance copy to come back from the customer, which makes it easy for them to return payment. And when it's sent to the customer, they receive a very professional looking document. Right here where the dotted line is, you can ask your printer to score just some plain copy paper for you, and that makes it very easy for your customer to tear and return a remittance copy to you. So now let's talk about the other report, and the expiring ones is how you create them in the first place. So I'm going to select expiring warranties, and I'm taken again to our search page, and we can use the date range, or typically someone might run these on a quarterly or a monthly basis. So let's find everything that is expiring this month. And you notice it automatically knows your current date, so it'll put in the start date and end date. And these are all listed for you here, and you can sort these down by anything that has an underline. So if I wanted to sort by the contact name, I can click on that. And that'll be first name, last name, or the address, or even the city. You can also do the same with service contact. So when you click a second time, this will sort in reverse order. So if we wanted to sort on the expiration date, you see it starts with the most current to the oldest. And if I reverse that, it starts with the oldest. So we have the scope of the work here. And we also have the name of the type of renewal. So if I sort by the category and reverse it, you see that we have several carpenter ant, but most of them are termites. You can omit something from the list if you want to by clicking this button here. So if I was to find this again, that would be omitted permanently from the list. It's not deleted, but it's something that you're not going to consider in the future. So maybe part of the condition of sale for a real estate transaction is that there's a one-year extension given to a warranty. You can, at this point, just click the Create Renewal. You'll be prompted as whether you want to use a service address or the billing address. So I'm going to choose a service address. And you'll see that we now have this notice. And I'll just say this was the first notice. And perhaps we want to go ahead and create our invoice. And so if this is paid from closing, go ahead and apply the payment. And you might even want to go over here and make a note, paid at closing. So now if we go back up to the reports menu, run our expiring warranties report again, you'll see now we're down to 12 records because that other record is no longer part of an expiring set. We can process all of our warranties at the same time, and it can be any combination. We see we have termite warranties, we have carpenter ant warranties. They could be inspection warranty renewals, but to process all of them at the same time, we just click the button that says Process Found Set. Confirm it. In this case, we're going to use the service address for all of these. And once they're created, it'll allow you to print the entire set. And keep in mind that you can also create a PDF like this and email that to your customer as well. So now if I go to the report menu, run my expiring warranties, and you'll see that no warranties are found in that date range. So if I go back and run the pending renewals, you'll see that those are all in the pending status now. So as these come in, you'll be able to go to the renewal, click the Create Invoice button. So we'll just take Fred Jones here. Want to create an invoice, and you can mark that invoice completed, and we can also mark the status of that renewed so that when you view it here in the history view, you can see the complete history of what's going on with that client. So there you are, the complete renewal process in SmartPest Paperless Office.